Hello and welcome to this video personal project phase 1 global contexts. And what this video is all about is sharing with you what the global contexts are and how they are related and relevant to your personal project. The global contexts are the contextual lens with which you see things around in the world. And through using these contexts, it allows you as an amazing, fantastic MYP student to inquire further into the topic that you are so passionate about and to extend your meaning and understanding of what you're looking at. So at the end, you have a wonderful, deep and meaningful personal project. So, what you need to know is that the global contexts are replacing the areas of interaction and that there are 6 global contexts from which you can choose from, and from that 6 you choose only 1. Before you choose the global context, you need to ask yourself these 4 questions. The first question is, what do you want to achieve through your personal project? Secondly, what do you want others to understand through your personal project? Thirdly, what impact do you want your personal project to have? And fourthly, how can the specific context give greater purpose to your personal project? What I'm going to do now is to run through the global contexts and provide some examples of personal project ideas which are connected with the global context. So the first is identities and relationships. And as part of identities and relationships, what you will explore is identity, beliefs and values, personal, physical, mental, social and spiritual health, human relationships, including families, friends, communities and cultures, and what it means to be human. When you're looking at identities and relationships as one context, and all of the other global contexts, what you need to make sure is that your project satisfies the majority or the most of those strands. That will ensure that you have a very deep and meaningful personal project. So, some examples of a topic that you could look at for identities and relationships and what the outcome or the product could well be. The first is, you may want to look at the effect of mass media on teenage identity, looking at the social networks, looking at Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, Instagram, Snapchat, and all of that. And how does that affect teenagers' identity? And your outcome or product for that could be a short film. Or you could look at the two sides of social networking, and you, as your product, you could create an awareness campaign about digital citizenship and cyberbullying. Those are just 2 possible suggestions, and I'm sure you guys and girls can think of something far more amazing than that. The second global context is orientation in space and time. And as part of orientation in space and time, you will look at personal histories, homes and journeys, turning points in humankind, discoveries, explorations and migrations of humankind, and the relationships between the and the interconnectedness of individuals and civilizations from personal, local and global perspectives. Now, some topics that you could look at, maybe the Mayflower, which was the boat which sailed from England to America, and looking at the dream of religious freedom and the personal family history of the first settlers in the American colonies. And your outcome or product may well be a written biography. Or you may wish to look at charting a family history through the archives, and you may produce an online blog of your own family's family history. The third global context is personal and cultural expression. And as part of that, you will explore the ways in which we discover and express ideas, feelings, nature, culture, beliefs, and values. The ways in which we reflect on, extend, and enjoy our creativity and our appreciation for the aesthetic. So, You may choose to look at the art of manga in Japanese culture, and your outcome or product could be a Japanese anime and a survey of the understanding of Japanese anime and the history and culture by your fellow peers. Or you could look at culture and self-expression through dance at the local community art center or a public place where you're happy to show your performance. And obviously, your outcome or product would be a live dance performance. The fourth global context is scientific and technical innovation. And as part of that, you will explore the natural world and its laws, the interaction between people and the natural world, how humans use their understanding of scientific principles, the impact of scientific and technological advances on communities and environments, and the impact of environments on human activity, and how humans adapt environments to their needs. Now, two topic ideas for scientific and technical information is that you may look at what's the matter with antimatter. And your outcome or product could well be an informational documentary, a website, a blog, a brochure, a presentation. Or you may choose to look at, can stem cells replace organ transplants? And you may wish to do an investigative report. Or you could look at how 3D printing could revolutionize the medical care which people now receive. And again, your product could be a short documentary, it could be a website, or it could be a report or a presentation. The fifth global context is globalization and sustainability. And as part of that, you will explore the interconnectedness of human-made systems and communities, the relationships between local and global processes, and how local experiences mediate the global, and the opportunities and tensions provided by world interconnectedness, and the impact of decision-making on humankind and the environment. Some topics which you may wish to look at as part of that is you may look at how education can be used as a tool to change the future of a certain country or a certain community. And you may design interactive resources for a workshop. Or you could look at the role of developing countries in protecting the tropical rainforest. And as part of that, you may create a collage model of photographs with explanations explaining what you've been looking at and what is the role of developing countries in protecting the tropical rainforest. The sixth and final global context which you may choose to look at is fairness and development. And as part of that, you may explore rights and responsibilities, the relationships between communities, sharing finite resources with other people and with other living things, access to equal opportunities, and peace and conflict resolution. As part of that is a topic which you may wish to look at. You may look to explore the intersections of race and inequality. And your product could well be a series of podcasts or a radio broadcast or a YouTube video, a series of them discussing that issue and allowing people to have access to it. You may wish to look into asylum seekers and their right to live like us in a certain country. And you may represent your knowledge and understanding of this through a painting. Or you may wish to look at something like child marriages and how that impacts people globally and how that impacts one's access to rights and their own freedoms. So, those are basically the six global contexts with ideas of what you could do as a topic and as a product. Let's just recap those global contexts once more. They are identities and relationships, orientation in space and time, personal and cultural expression, scientific and technical innovation, globalization and sustainability, and fairness and development. And you can find all of this information in pages 6, 7, 8, and 9 of your personal project handbook. Thank you. My name is John Harvey, and thanks for watching. Goodbye.